Filipina boxer Nesty Petesho makes history after punching her way to silver in the Tokyo Olympics women's featherweight final Tuesday, August 3. The feat makes Petesho the first Filipina boxer to win an Olympic medal. Japan's Senna Airy, who previously denied Petesho an Olympic berth in the Asia and Oceania qualifiers, repeats another win over the Filipina by unanimous decision. In men's boxing, Carlo Paalam pulls off the greatest upset win of his life after defeating the 2016 Rio Olympics gold medalist and 2019 world champion from Uzbekistan. This assures him of a bronze, the fourth Olympic medal for the Philippines, surpassing the country's multiple medal count in the 1932 Los Angeles Games. Paalam will face Japanese Hombet Ryomi Tanaka in the semi-final on Thursday, August 5 at 1:30 p.m. Philippine time. Meantime, EJ Obiena ends his Olympic campaign in the men's pole vault final. Obiena bows out of the medal contention after three unsuccessful attempts at 5.80 meters. Over a month after declaring Metro Manila low risk for COVID-19, the health department says the capital region is back to a high-risk classification due to the increase in cases. Aside from Metro Manila, Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere on Tuesday, August 3, also tags the following areas as high-risk due to their high average daily attack rate: Central Visayas, Ilocos Region, Cagayan Valley, Cordillera Administrative Region, and Northern Mindanao. In July, the World Health Organization cautioned the DOH to be careful in tagging the Philippines as low risk for COVID-19. The WHO said giving the public the wrong messaging could result in lower compliance to minimum public health standards. As Metro Manila braces for the strictest lockdown from August 6 to 20, the Department of Transportation assures there will still be mass transportation during the ECQ period. The current 50% capacity in public utility vehicles remains, but only authorized persons outside of residents will be allowed to board PUVs. In Cebu, 132 health frontliners who live in the city test positive for COVID-19, worsening the hospital personnel shortage amid a surge in cases. The infected health workers work for 31 hospitals, medical clinics, facilities, offices, and laboratories in Metro Cebu. 95% of the infected health workers are asymptomatic. In related news, Japanese researchers find another highly infectious variant of the coronavirus called the Lambda variant. First identified in Peru and now spreading in South America, the Lambda variant is reportedly more resistant to vaccines than the original version of the coronavirus. Researchers warn, with Lambda being labeled a variant of interest by the WHO rather than a variant of concern, people might not realize it is a serious ongoing threat. Senator Franklin Drilon backs the decision of Vice President Lenny Robredo to pursue talks for a broader coalition to represent the opposition in the 2022 elections. This comes after former Senator Sonny Trillanes said Robredo should not engage in possible coalition talks with other potential presidential bets like Senators Panfilo Lacson and Richard Gordon. Drilon adds Robredo's actions do not mean she has already given up on a presidential bid.
It is difficult enough to present yourself as an alternative to this administration if we are not united. But I don't agree with Senator Trillanes that we should not talk to other prospective candidates. I think we should have a big tent wherein we can attract all people, all sectors who believe that the next administration should not be identified with the present administration. And therefore, a broader coalition is necessary.
Robredo said these talks were focused only on finding commonalities for now. Trillanes had warned his party, Magdalo, will withdraw support for Robredo and the Liberal Party should the vice president give way to Lacson. Meanwhile, in President Rodrigo Duterte's weekly public addresses, he openly spoke of his wish for two cabinet members to run in the 2022 senatorial elections. Instead of giving regular updates about the raging COVID-19 pandemic, Duterte urged Transportation Secretary Arthur Tugade and Public Works Secretary Mark Villar to run for the Senate. Villar was a star in the most recent Talk to the People aired on Monday, August 2. 40 minutes was devoted to his presentation on roads, bridges, and classrooms built during the Duterte presidency. At the end of his presentation, Duterte profusely praised Villar.
Manghinayang ako pag tumakbo ka ng senador at manalo ka naman, mawalaan yung executive department ng mga taong kagaya mo.
In the July 28 Talk to the People, Duterte turned the spotlight on Tugade, saying almost exactly the same thing.
And I hope that you'd consider running for Senator of the Republic of the Philippines. Sayang ka. Sayang ka toto. Nanginayang ako sa inyo.
Duterte's endorsement of his cabinet officials comes as the country faces a new jump in cases of COVID-19, the reason behind the 15-day lockdown of the capital region that begins on August 6. Senator Franklin De Leon described the proposal to double the 2022 budget of the government's anti-communist insurgency task force as an election giveaway.
Do not forget that 2022 is an election year. And therefore, these amounts of money available is a campaign kitty, whether you like it or not.
Delon says sources from the budget department disclosed to him an alleged plan to increase the NTF-LCAC's budget to as much as 40 billion pesos next year. Interior Secretary Eduardo Anyo himself earlier said the national government would fight for a 40 billion peso budget for NTF-LCAC in 2022 to provide barangay development projects for 2,000 villages cleared of communist influence. Delon says a good chunk of NTF-LCAC's budget allocations are for soft programs for maintenance and other operating expenses, which can easily be manipulated. Delon reiterates he would oppose the passage of the NTF-LCAC's budget in 2022 and hopes other senators would back him up. In April, De Leon led 14 other senators in filing a resolution that seeks to censure former NTF-LCAC spokesperson Lieutenant General Antonio Barlade Jr. for his disrespectful, derogatory, and demeaning remarks against the legislators. Barlade called senators stupid when they threatened to defund the NTF-LCAC in 2021 after he read that community pantry organizers. Malacañang is expected to submit its proposed 2022 national budget to Congress sometime in August. The Miss Universe Philippines on Monday, August 2, announces the 15 delegates who earned the highest votes during the headshot challenge. Actress Kisses de la Vin earns the top spot, followed by TikTok influencer Rosane Marie Bernos and 2017 Asia's Next Top Model winner Maureen Robelwitz. The rest of the top 15 for the headshot challenge are the following. The voting for the headshot challenge ran from July 26 to midnight of August 1. Only registered users of the Miss Universe Philippines app were able to vote for their favorite delegate once a day. Meantime, K-pop girl group Red Velvet finally reveals their comeback date and album release details. On Monday, August 2, Red Velvet drops the first teaser for their upcoming 6th mini-album, Queendom, which will be released on August 16. The announcement comes after their Queen's Mystic General Store project ended on Sunday, August 1. For the week-long promotional project, Red Velvet releases a series of archive videos from their B-side tracks, as well as mementos from their previous releases. Fans are anticipating Queendom, as the upcoming album will mark Red Velvet's first group release since December 2019.